Hey friends, Jill here. Welcome back to Whispering Willow Farms. I am cozy in my living room right now with my cup of coffee and the fire's going. And I am rummaging through seed catalogs and through my seed inventory, which kind of sparked this video you have today. If you are anything like me, we keep a budget. And I know spending hundreds of dollars at one time on seeds is something that I am never prepared for. When I'm spending money, especially like large chunks at one time, I have issues with that. I'm one of those types of people that I can spend money, like if they are a low amount all day long, like that's okay. But when it comes to like $100 or more, or honestly probably like $50 or more, that's like an investment to me. And so I have to think through it. I have to process it. I am not one of those that just like can impulse buy at all. I say that with an impulse buy behind me. Nathan was so supportive of that, okay? So I'm gonna blame that one on Nathan. But as I'm sitting here thinking, you know, I can't be the only one who doesn't wanna spend hundreds of dollars at a time on seeds. I can't be the only one who is opening up their seed catalog and thinking, okay, I have to keep a budget. I have to do this to where it's not gonna break the bank. And so these are some things that I do every single year when it comes to buying my seeds. And I can tell you right now, it has saved my family a lot of money. And before, I would rummage through seed catalogs. I would do this right here. I would flip the pages. I would find what was beautiful. And I was like, I have got to have that. I don't know where I'm gonna plant it. I don't know if I'm even gonna plant it, but I know that that is cool, it is pretty, and I'm buying it. And I've realized through the years, you can't do that. Well, I mean, you could technically. But for someone who is trying to get by budget friendly, who is trying to not overspend, who's trying to really think through what they're planting, why they're planting, the market, you know, all of those different things, I approach a seed catalog a lot different now than I did in the past. So let's dive in. Let me throw these helpful tips out at you just to kind of relieve the stress for you. Maybe if you're anything like me and you get a little stressed out when it comes to buying seeds for next year. The first thing that I do is I check my current seed inventory. Most of the times I have my seeds stored in these bins and I write on there. So this is tomatoes, cherry and slicers, and then I have peppers. This over here is herbs, flowers, and extras. Then I've got more that is my greens. I've got root vegetables. I've got winter crops, summer crops. And this kind of helps me stay a bit organized. As you can see, it's still madness. Right now I have some stuff that I was sowing out and they're just thrown in here. But I feel like if you break whatever seeds you have up currently into categories, and then you can shop your own inventory, it makes a huge difference. And then what I'm doing is I'm just getting a notepad and I'm writing seed inventory, and I will go tomatoes, how many I have. So if say it is a German pink tomato and I have got 2 packs, I'll put German pink times 2, and that way I know. And I will get a good inventory. Now typically I am only doing this in the fall and the winter for the spring and the summer. And that is because I grow a lot. And that is when I'm growing for profit. The fall and winter garden is just leisure for my family. It's fun. It's just what I grow for my family. I'm not selling it. So I don't worry about, I usually always have enough, and it's not like I'm having to buy a larger quantity of seeds or anything like that. So usually I have enough and I'm just keeping an eye, and I know when the summer's wrapping up, okay, I'll do a quick inventory, but it's not near as in-depth. And I'll just order a few seeds here and there, and that's enough. I mean, usually one seed packet for the fall and the winter, say it's cabbages, I mean, and there's 100 seeds in that pack, I'm typically good to go. Now this is the fun part. Once you have figured out your seed inventory, what you're working with starting out, then you get to shop the catalog. And this is fun. You do get to go through, I usually get post-it notes and mark it. I have my pen or my marker and I'm checking everything that I wanna go back and look at. Now first, I'm gonna check everything. I'm gonna check anything that may spark my interest, that I'm curious about growing, wanting to sell, or whatever, no matter what catalog that it is. I usually have several. I'll have Baker Creek's, I'll have Johnny's, a botanical interest, stuff like that, and that's what I'm doing. I'm going through and I'm marking everything. then I will go back through and I will narrow it down, because I do grow things that spark joy and I do grow things that bring me happiness. But I know on a large scale, I can maybe choose, typically it's like between 3 and 5 new things that I grow each year, and I keep it pretty small because I don't have a ton of growing space that we're working with. And I really want to save that space for my production crops, the ones that I know I can sell. I personally believe once you check your own inventory and you're going through here, say if I never checked my inventory and I'm just, you know, thinking off of last year, you know, I don't have enough German pinks, and I'm gonna go ahead and buy, and I may be overbuying, which is causing me to spend more money than I really needed to buy had I just done proper inventory to begin with. So I have found, used to, I never really worried about my inventory. I just always kept buying, and I realized really wasn't a smart way. It wasn't really a good approach. So I'll go through and I'll put it in tomatoes and peppers. Then I'll put it in, you know, like if I'm gonna do any herbs or flowers. This year we are honing in primarily on flowers. So I'm gonna be buying a lot of flowers, which I don't really have hardly any flowers. I've saved my seeds. So I'm gonna be going through all of these, and as you can already see, I've got some X's on here, some marks of some ones that I want to grow. And then I'll go back through and I will do research on those, and I will figure out, okay, in my area, can I sell these? I will talk to the people who I'm planning on selling to, asking them, hey, what varieties are you buying from other farmers? That way I can buy and grow something different. That way I know it's already sold pretty much at the beginning of the season. So if you're in a similar situation like me and you're trying to push out your product, you're trying to sell your produce or your flowers or whatever that may be, talk to whoever you plan on selling to and just ask them, hey, I am getting ready to buy my seeds for next season. Is there something you would like to see? And if I grew it, would you buy it? And a lot of times they are very receptive. They will tell you, the person that I sell to when it comes to flowers, she told me exactly what flowers, what variety she didn't have and what she wanted to have, and that's exactly what I'm gonna buy. Something else that I am always looking at is promotional codes or free shipping. Right now, Botanical Interest, who I'm going to be buying majority of my flower seeds from for the spring, November 1st through November 25th, they have free shipping over $50, which I was going to place my order last week, and it was a pretty large order, and my shipping was gonna be like $18. So I didn't order because I was like, oh man, how was it? You know, I had this budget in mind. Then with the shipping, it put it over what that budget was. So I waited, and I'm glad I did, because I received an email that there's free shipping over $50. So a lot of people offer that. Hostools offers that a lot of times. Botanical Interest, like I said, has that going on right now. Johnny's will. So look at that. Also, just simply put in a Google search, you know, promo codes for Hostools, and you'll see what they have and apply those promo codes, which is something that I do often. When you're putting in a bigger order, that $18 in shipping, well, that's $18 worth of free seed I could buy. If you're looking at it that way, when I was, you know, talking through this with Nathan, he's like, well, yeah, I mean, no brainer. Just take that money you would have spent on shipping and buy more seeds. So that's also a good way to be budget friendly. Always just do a quick little Google search, sign up for those promotional emails. For me, I like being flooded with all, you know, the seed company's things. I like seeing what they're coming out with. I like seeing seasonally. Botanical Interest, I got on their website this morning, and they have like these kid packs and holiday packs and all these other packs and bundles you can buy, which are also cheaper if you do that. So I plan on taking advantage of that and buying some of these bundles and getting them at a discounted rate as well. I will list all of the seed companies that I plan on buying from below this year, primarily. A lot of Hostools, a lot of Johnny's, a lot of Botanical Interests. There are a lot of great seed companies though. So figure out, you may just want to buy local, and that's okay. I've also found for me personally, if I can, so I start seeds around the end of January. So really fall, November, December, I need to be buying the bulk of my seeds, really October, November, December. I'm already in November right now. So right now is when I'm honing in. Like I said, I don't like spending large amounts at one time. So I'm gonna be putting in this order now. Then I'll wait a couple weeks, and now if I realize I need some more, I'm just going to be gradually buying seeds as I feel like I need them. instead of buying bulk, realizing I overbought, didn't actually need it, right now, just because we did have a major seed shortage in the spring, I'm kind of nervous, if I'm being honest. I want to make sure that I have enough flowers to sell. I want to make sure that I have enough food to grow for my family and put up and things like that. So I am probably going to be throwing on a couple things extra this year, just as a precautionary, honestly. But I've realized that if I wait until these seed companies have these promos and I snag them and then say I wait until they do another promo or they're giving away some free seeds or something like that, snagging them again, it doesn't hurt near as bad. I'm obviously spending the same amount of money, I know, but it makes me feel better if I'm gradually doing it as I have extra money in our budget versus spending a huge lump sum right off the bat. And it may be the same way for you. You may have to sell some plants or plant starts or whatever and then use that money and buy some. And then as you get other money or, you know, in through different revenues, take that and buy seeds as well. And so these are just things, someone who is just spending money that the farm makes on stuff like that, I tend to just do it a gradual thing. That way it's not just hitting me all at once. I get asked a lot of questions about this because I've mentioned it in my videos before, and that is seed swaps. I would love to be in a place to be able to host seed swaps. You know, saving, I'm starting to save a lot more of my seeds than I have in the past. Like right now, I just don't have a ton of saved seeds. But more people used to do seed swaps. I remember a few years ago, people who aren't even on Instagram anymore were doing all of these seed swaps. And I get asked a lot, what seed swaps, you know, are you a part of? The people that I, because I've went back and looked, the people that I've done their seed swaps for years are like just gone. They're just not on Instagram or social media anymore. But if you just send out an in search of seed swaps, I'm sure you will be able to be connected to someone in your community. And then also just put out there, I do this a lot. I'm like, okay, do you want to trade seeds? I have an excess amount, like right now I have a lot of zinnia seeds and I don't have a lot of tomato seeds. So, hey, if I send you some of my zinnia seeds that I saved, do you have any tomato seeds you could send me and let's just trade? I think that there is something really cool about that. I love getting seeds that people have saved from their gardens all around the world. I have a piece of you or somebody else in my garden here in Arkansas, and you could be from a totally different place, and there was love that you poured into your garden that I am now taking and receiving the bounty of and planting in my garden to then give to someone else. And just that whole circle, I love it. If you've been following me, you know I love growing food. I am so passionate about it. And for me, the garden is more than just growing food. The garden is growing relationships, growing friendships. It's teaching my children. It's pouring into my community. It's all these different things for me. So being able to trade seeds or participate in seed swaps, for me, I cannot recommend you guys do that more. So now that I have kind of given you guys some of the tips that I do when I'm searching through my seed catalog, when I'm getting ready to place my orders for the next season, I hope that this was helpful. I hope that it kind of makes the whole process of rummaging through these catalogs a bit easier. You know, you kind of have a plan in place now. Now, of course, if you want to just scroll through here and if you don't sell your food, maybe you're beginning a garden and you just want to grow what sparks joy. You just want to grow something fun. I support you in that 100%. The reason why I'm growing food is profit for a large amount in the spring and the summer. So when I look through the seed catalog, my needs are going to be different than your needs, and that's okay. But I do encourage you, whether you're growing for profit or you're growing for fun or for your family or whatever that may be, do grow something every year that's going to spark joy, that is going to bring you happiness, that you're going to walk out into the garden after a long day and you're going to be reminded why you planted this garden to begin with. I think that there is a lot to be said about that, and at the end of the day, you have to feed your soul and you have to keep rejuvenating yourself. And if that is just by growing something for fun, by all means, grow it. The Tremboncino squash is one of those things for me. We don't sell it. It's not a good seller at all. Not because it doesn't taste well, just because it's different. And a lot of people don't know what to do with it. But I grow it every single year because it brings me a lot of happiness. I think they are fascinating. I can grow squash taller than my kids. Like, that's cool. So I'll always grow that and just know that I'm not gonna sell it, but that's okay because when I walk through the garden and I see it, it makes me happy. But I hope you guys have your cup of coffee, cup of tea, sitting in your cozy place, rummaging through your seed catalog, and you just think about these helpful little tips and tricks that I threw out there today. But thank you guys so much for hanging out with me, and I'll talk to you soon.